there's something due any day, I will know right away, soon as it shows. It may come cannonballing down through the sky, gleaming its eye bright as a rose. Who knows? It's only just out of reach, down the block, on a beach, under a tree. I got a feeling there's a miracle due, gonna come true, come unto me. Could it be? Yes, it could. Something's coming, something good, if I can wait. Something's coming, I don't know what it is, but it is gonna be great. With a click, with a shock, phone will jingle, door will knock, open the latch. Something's coming, don't know when, but it's soon, catch the moon, one-handed catch. Around the corner, a whistling down the river. Come on, deliver to me. Will it be? Yes, it will. Maybe just by holding still, it'll be there. Come on, something, come on in. Don't be shy, need a guy, pull up a chair. Yeah, it's for me. And something great is coming. It's only just out of reach, down the block, on a beach. Maybe tonight, maybe tonight, maybe tonight.
And get ready, because right now, if your TV picture becomes a blur of red and white, don't adjust your set. It's the arrival of the University of Oklahoma Marching Band.
The 280 members are known as the Pride of Oklahoma, and they're under the direction of Gene Thrailkill.
If they look like they own this town, you can't blame them. In the past 10 years, the football team has played in the Orange Bowl an unbelievable 7 times.
And that includes tomorrow's game against number one ranked Penn State.
Right, the national championship at stake. And you can see it right here on NBC tomorrow night, immediately following the Rose Bowl.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, under the direction of Mr. Gene Trailfield, director of the University Band, and led on the field by drumming to Johnny Gunn, we proudly present 1985-86 Ride of Oklahoma!
Yes. Now taking the field here at the Orange Bowl, the Pride of Oklahoma Marching Band.
Sooners, 142 to play, and they own it. hope you understand that it's very sincere. Thank you very much. Thank you.
join the university band in the singing of the University of Oklahoma chant, conducted by Mr. Gene Thrailkill, director of university bands. gentlemen, the 1985 Pride of Oklahoma. We'll be right back.
somewhere.
Ladies and gentlemen, under the direction of Mr. Gene Thrillkill, director of University Bands, and led on the field by assistant drum major Steve Mays, we proudly present the 1985 Pride of Oklahoma!
Thank you.
National Collegiate Band that will perform in New York City this summer for the unveiling of the refurbished Statue of Liberty on the 4th of July. At the same time, bands around the nation will be celebrating a year of tribute to John Philip Sousa. Mr. Sousa was an American phenomenon and ranks as one of the most important composers in the musical history of our country. Dubbed the March King, his marches became the music of America. The music that welcomed kings and other world leaders to our shores, and the music that invented foot tapping. The Pride of Oklahoma has discovered a reincarnated John Philip Sousa, a reincarnation at least in spirit. Today we welcome Mr. James G. Sate, who is known nationally as a spinning image of Sousa. Dressed in authentic Sousa uniform, Mr. Sate helps to recreate the time and emotion of the era in concerts he performs around the nation. This afternoon, we are proud to welcome a native Oklahoman to the podium, the reincarnated John Philip Sousa.
We'll be right back. Good afternoon, Sooner fans. Do you know where your band is? Observing All Hallows Eve, or Halloween as you know it. As legend has it, Halloween is the time when the souls of the dead revisit their homes. It is a time to placate the supernatural powers controlling the processes of nature. In recent times, Halloween has become a time of mischief-making, trick-or-treat, and tale-telling. Today is no different. The Pride of Oklahoma now remet. Guys, the band is the other way. There, that's better. The Pride of Oklahoma now remembers that day when the spirit of half times past claimed Owen Field. But a young twirler, she was so sweet and innocent. But now in her final year with the band, she's become a real little stinker. The Pride now features solo twirler Miss Jennifer Horn, twirling to the blockbuster hit, Ghostbusters. We'll be right back. there are still many mysteries in this world, many places which defy explanation. All Hallows' Eve comes but once a year, but there is still one place on this earth where it's always Halloween! Much like today, when the spirits of the band took control and ran rampant in the stadium. But this is 1985. We don't believe in witches, ghosts, and goblins anymore. Oh no, it can't be. I don't believe it. It's the spirit of halftime's past. Oh great spirit, hear our plea. Release the souls of the band so they may once again walk the face of the turf. Please, oh almost great one, lead our marchers to the promised sidelines. We'll be right back.
Johnny, we have to talk. But first, you got to promise me you're going to be strong. We both have to be strong. It's about George.
There's a cowboy in the jungle, and he looks so out of place. With his shrimp skin boots and his cheap cheroots, and his skin as white as paste. Heading south to Paraguay, where the gauchos sing and shout. Now he's stuck in Portobello since his money all ran out. So he hangs out with the sailors, night and day they're raising hell. And his original destination's just another story that he loves to tell.
Just 5 more miles.
With no plans for the future, he still seems in control. From a Bronco ride to a 10-foot tie, he just had to learn to roll. Roll with the punches, played all of his hunches, made the best of whatever came his way. What he lacked in ambition, he made up with intuition. And their music floats across the bay, while American women and moo-moos talk about all the things they did today. And their husbands quack about fishing as they slug those rum drinks down, discussing who caught what and who sat on his butt. But it's the only show in town. They're trying to all may lose their lunches, trying to cram lost years in 5 or 6 days. Seems that blind ambition erased their intuition, plowing straight ahead, come what may. Can count the falling stars, while the Southern Cross and the satellites, they remind me of where we are. Spinning around in circles, living it day to day, and still 24 hours, maybe 60 good years. It's really not that long a stay. We gotta punches, learn to play all of our hunches, make the best of whatever comes your way. Forget that blind ambition and learn to trust your intuition, plowing straight ahead, come what may.
George Ryan. Lousy scumbag.
God bless my underwear. My only pair. Through the washer, the dryer, on the clothesline and blowing in the air. Through the disco, through the rodeo, through Form 1040A, please save my seat. God bless my underwear, my only pair. God bless my underwear, my only pair.